Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Are you interested in having plumper lips but don't want fillers or neuromodulators like Botox? Today, I'm going to talk about it all natural ways, three different ways that might suit you so that you can get plumper lips without having fillers and toxins. If you like these videos, don't forget to subscribe below and join our family. We have all kinds of tips and tricks to keep your skin youthful and beautiful. Today we're talking lip plumping. So lips are common, they're sought after, they're all the rage all over social media. You see it on Instagram, you see underdone, you see overdone. People are fearful of getting them done. And a lot of people, either they're not allowed to get neuromodulators like Botox or fillers by their partner or spouse, or they're just afraid and they don't want to go down that route and they're afraid to look unnatural. For some people, they want to start with an all-natural way or a minimal way to build the lip up a little bit. Part of an overall aesthetic look, and on this channel we often talk about how to stay looking natural, how dimensions work with the lips. Well, the lips reduce in size, plumpness, and they get more and more fine lines over time naturally. In fact, from the age of 23, 24, unfortunately, lip volume goes down. And lip volume plays a role not only in beauty, but also in dimensions on the face. And remember, beauty is math, so it's a mathematical formula, at least external beauty is. And having smaller lips will help the mouth turn down, look negative, it takes away from a look. But vibrant pink lips are associated with better hormones, youth, attractiveness, fertility, all those kinds of things that are positive. The negative is when they're overdone. So what are the natural ways to start with? And you can start, we'll start with topicals, then we're going to go to radio frequency, and then the last one, which I love, we're going to talk about. So let's start with topicals. Many people are willing to do topicals not only for skincare, but for drug delivery and different things because it's fairly easy. You can do it at home. Keep in mind, the biggest thing with topicals of any sort is just that it's delivery, it's getting it to the deeper tissues. And that's what everyone's working on from a topical perspective, be it drug delivery, immunizations are used through topicals, and there's even a hyaluron pen that I'll do a whole separate video on that drives hyaluronic acid without needles into the tissues, and we'll go through that in a whole separate video coming up, so stay tuned. On the topical front, there's three main ingredients that lead to bigger lips. And I'm a fan of these. They can work very, very well. We have one in our line of skincare that patients just love. And the ingredients in different one or different types of topicals are somewhat similar. The percentages can be different. So the first thing is you see a type of venom, a type of maybe a snake venom or a bee sting venom. And those are often peptides, they can be irritants, and just by irritating the skin, you can get plumping effect. So those are, that's the first group of ingredients. The next is essential oils, and they can be, I'll list some right over here, a whole group of essential oils that can irritate the skin, they cause a little bit of a reaction. And so the skin wants to plump up a little bit, it wants to react to it, and they can work within minutes to plump it, make it more red, and increase blood flow. The third group is humectants, or things that draw water in. So common ones, of course, people know hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid draws 1,000 times its weight, molecular weight, of water in. So bringing water in to the skin then makes it look red, more plump. Remember, you have to be hydrated for that to happen, and or there has to be moisture from the outside. The water has to come from somewhere, and we'd much rather it come from outside than taking your body's water. Although if you're very hydrated, that's okay. So those three ingredients that you might look for, here's the distinguishing factor often between them. Some products may have those ingredients. Look for high percentages. So Raj's recommendation, topical works great. It can work if you have fillers and toxin, of course, but as a standalone, if you want to start there, they're very good. And ours happens to have peptides. You can look for peptides in the one that you choose. And studies have shown ours, when you stop it at day one, 30 days later, the lips are bigger than they were at baseline. So look, sometimes you'll see studies or white papers done with these, and that often helps you know that you have a great product and then that will work. You can try different ones as well. What kind of size can you expect from a topical? Typically anywhere from 10 to 15% increase in size. And you apply it, they work within minutes. There's an effect that will last anywhere from 30 minutes to 3 or 4 hours. And then, like I said, if there's peptides or other ingredients, you're going to get a longer lasting effect. So if you skip a few days in between, you still have a little more luscious, red, juicy lip that people want. And remember, the water comes from somewhere. So better they work when there's moisture outside or you're hydrated from within. So that's the story on topicals. I love them. They can be used several times a day with and without toxin filler or as a standalone. Let us know which one you prefer, and we'll go on to number two for natural looking lips. So the second way, and this is a relatively new way, is using energy devices. So electricity, it boils down to, and what we do is radio frequency. And by using an energy device like this, we can stimulate collagen in the lip. We stimulate an immediate plumping effect as well, just like we did with the topicals, but there's no injections with this. There's no factors outside of your body that are going to stimulate the collagen. So we're not injecting a foreign body or substance. We're not even putting a topical on, other than just a gel, like an ultrasound gel to couple. And bipolar radio frequency is what you want to look for here. Here, I use a Viora device because it's bipolar. But one of the main things is, of course, the lip is just a little bit of its mucous membrane, which helps those topicals I talked about work. It's a little bit of fat and then a lot of muscle. So the lip is mainly muscle. But you want to have a radio frequency device that can work superficially. And that's the key in all of this. So by using different modes on a device like this, radio frequency bipolar, meaning the energy goes from one electrode to the other, that way it doesn't go through the body or get too deep. And you all know this from radio frequency or high frequency ultrasound devices that have been thought to cause fat reduction or hollows, or people have had high frequency ultrasound said, hey, I lost fat in my face because of it. Certainly the fat in the lip is very precious. You want to keep it all, just like the forehead. There's not much there, so you better keep it so you don't have to add to it. Same in the lip. But by using superficial radio frequency, stimulating collagen growth and immediate redness plumping, and more importantly, long-term effects. And here are a few pictures I'll show you. Here's a before and after of two sessions. We usually do three sessions, spaced out by 10 to 14 days. Here's two sessions, and there's the before and after. And here's another one, same thing. This is 3 weeks after two sessions of radio frequency, and we call it Plump RF. And it works very well. There's minimal pain. You don't need anesthetic. And it's all natural. Nothing injected, no topicals. You can obviously use your lip plumper topicals with it too before you have to go to the third stage, which we'll go to now. So the third part of the equation, and I love this, I call it PlasmaLip. You can go to PlasmaLip.com if you want to read more, research more about it. I think we have videos here on YouTube. I'll put a link up here as well for PlasmaLip. What it is using platelet-rich fibrin, and you'll know it well because I use it with PlasmaSculpt, PlasmaGlo, PlasmaBoosters, and PlasmaLip. It's when we take your blood, we spin it down, there's no additives, no heparin, no sodium citrate, there's no plastic separator tube like it's in PRP, and it's highly concentrated growth factors, stem cells from your own blood. It takes a little more to produce this product. You have to have the right system. There's no separator plug like in PRP. So we're pulling up exactly the layer we want, high concentration of platelets. Remember, how does this work? If you cut yourself, the platelets go, and what platelets do is they coagulate it. And what do? They form a fiber clot. And this clot, if you take it off, you pull the scab off, of course, you don't heal as well. So you can't do that with PRP because there's heparin in the tube and it doesn't form clotting. This will form a clot, which is why when we use it under the eyes, you see a little bit of a baggy eye for a few days. And when we put it in the lip will be a little larger than we want for a few days and it will come down nicely. But that vibrant clot will then release growth factors over the week, and they're your own body's concentrated growth factors of platelets. Around those platelets, of course, are the stem cells and growth factors because the body's trying to heal that wound. So all your body's factors are going into the lip, the upper and lower. I use a microcannula, and the lip certainly will be larger than we want it to be. And as it comes down, those growth factors release. What we're doing is plumping the fat up a little bit. Certainly we see a redder, more pink color to the lip. Those fine lines start to go away and you get the plumping effect. The lip just looks more youthful. Now you can do this if you've had fillers before. You can do it with the Plump RF and the topical. A great combination would be you're using your lip plumper at home, you do Plump RF, and you can do the PlasmaLip at the same time. You can also do them separately, because for some people they want to do it gradually and they don't want too much at once. But know when you do a procedure like this, the lips will be larger than you want. So someone at home, spouse, husband, girlfriend, boyfriend, and men do this, of course, because it looks good for men too. They lose lip volume too. But so remember that someone will know that you had PlasmaLip done the day of and the next day, maybe even out 3 days. Why people like that is because you get to see your lips larger, medium, and then a little bit smaller. So you get to see it. If you like them at the very large stage or the medium to large, you can add hyaluronic acid filler down the road and see if you like the look. So it's kind of a test run, but it's long-term plumping of lips. How often would someone do that? So the topical, of course, that I talked about, you would do that whenever you want, several times a day. Of course, you're going to skip days. The Plump RF, you do a series of three. Some people, like I showed you the picture, will stop at two, and then they might add as they want to plump up. Some people get such a response that they don't want the third, because part of the reason they're doing all natural, they don't want the spouse, friends, or family to know they're doing it. So just come in when you want. Probably you're going to come in every 2 to 3 months of a touch-up of that Plump RF. But everyone's going to be different. Everyone's going to be at different stages. People build collagen differently. So you can't really answer that. Certainly it could last someone 6 months to a year. That would be normal too. The other thing is I always talk about what happens when people see it, they love it, they naturally want more. So people who get PlasmaLip, we can also break up the vertical lip lines and they reduce. And I should mention, if they're minor and people have minor vertical lip lines, the topical will help with those. Certainly the Plump RF will help with those. And just going through with the cannula and with my PlasmaSculpt procedure, I include PlasmaLip and we go through with the cannula, break up the vertical lip lines, add a bit of a PRF there as well, because no one wants vertical lip lines. So all of these procedures, non-toxin, and you're not getting fillers, but they will help with vertical lip lines. Now, are there a group of people that are going to want fillers, they're going to want bigger lips, or that start with the topical, go to the radio frequency Plump RF, go to the PlasmaLip, and then want fillers? Of course, it's a natural human progression, and many people won't go past the topical, the RF, Plump RF, or the PlasmaLip. That's all they need. There's no real way to tell, but certainly the larger lips, the younger you are, the less aggressive to be. The caveat there is the younger want bigger, and the people who tend to have an older demographic, they are afraid that other people are going to know. One thing's for sure in closing, a natural lip may not be what you want. And I want you to think about that. We're going to do a whole video on, do you really want to look natural? because a natural lip has low volume, downturn of the mouth, and vertical lip lines. That naturally happens, especially skin type 1 to 3. As the lip loses volume, people talk and move and become hyperdynamic, loss of bone, loss of collagen. Vertical lip lines are a normal part of skin type 1 through 3 over time, if you wait long enough. So a natural lip, I would submit most people do not want a natural lip. What they're fearful of is an unnatural lip. And remember, a lot of these products are studied. So if you're doing neuromodulators, Botox, one of the most studied drugs on the planet Earth, and fillers, they're very well studied. But for those wanting au naturel, consider those treatments. I love them, and they can be used in any combinations with other procedures. But what you don't want to do is suction cups and all the bizarre things that you hear on the internet and see. So stay tuned here, subscribe for continued helpful tips. I'm going to post some links in the description below of other lip videos you can watch for filling, the tenting technique, a natural lip filler, dissolving, all those points of lip filler we cover on this channel. And stay tuned here to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.